Hello everyone, my name is Assistant Professor Vidisha Kapse. I am from the Department of Zoology, KSKW College, SIDCO, Nasik. Today, I am going to deliver my lecture on topic External Morphology of Fishes, which comes under the subject Ichthyology. First of all, what is Ichthyology? Ichthyology is the branch of science that deals with the study of fishes. In this figure, we can see that general external morphology of fish. There are many organs which can be seen by our naked eyes, like the mouth, eyes, operculum, lateral line. There are some fins are present on the body of the fish, like the dorsal fin, adipose fin, caudal fin, anal fin, pelvic fin, pectoral fin, etc. As we know, there are many variations seen in the fishes in their shapes as well as size also. In the diagram, we can see that there are various shapes are seen. Some are cylindrical, some are globular, some are kite shape, some have triangular shape like this. Here, we can see that fish morphology and fish shapes in the various forms. First one is a fusiform, which is seen in the tuna, in which the middle part of the fish is somewhat globular and it get tapers at the both ends. Then second one is a compressive forms, in which it is seen in the tautog. Next one is a diphrasive form. It is seen in the skates. This shape is some like a kite shape. Next is an anguli form, in which it is seen in the eel fishes. The shape is a cylindrical. Next one is a filly form, which is known as a pipe fish also. Next is a tinny form. The shape is ribbon-like also. Next is sagittary form, which have the snake-like head. Next is a glovy form, in which fish shape is circular type. Okay, let us discuss one by one. First one is a streamline or the fusiform. In the streamline, this shape is made up for the stability and the maneuverability. Means that coordination in the movement and for their skill development. Next one is a elongate. In the torpedo-like fish, it is seen. It is somewhat cylindrical. They have snout-like mouth. Next is a surface-oriented fish, in which their mouth is oriented in upward direction, as we seen in the figure. It is seen in the mosquito fish. Second one is a bottom rower, in which fish mouth is oriented downward direction. And it is surrounded by the many barbels. Next is a bottom clinger. In the bottom clinger, special organ is present, as we seen in the diagram, by which the fish can cling to the surface. They have the flattened head and large pectoral structure. It is seen in the sculpin, gobies, cling fishes. Next shape is a flat fish, in which body is dorsoventrally flattened. It is seen in the skates and the rays. Next shape is a rat-tail fish. In the rat-tail fish, their tail is elongated and their mouth is present snout-like. It is seen in the deep-sea dweller and the chimeras. Next body shape is a deep-bodied fish, in which their body is somewhat globular at the middle. This is adapted for the maneuverability, that is coordination in the movement. Next shape is a eel-like fish, in which body is cylindrical and many appendages are absent in this body. Many fins are absent. It is seen in the eel and loaches. There are two types of fishes which swims with swims with the trunk and tail, and other swims with the fins. The fishes which swims with the trunk and tail, we can see their body shapes is different than that swims with the fins. In the fishes that swims with the fins, we can see the various types of fins are adapted for the swimming. Next organ in the fish is seen the scales. Scales are the important because they covers the body of the fishes. They are a protective organ which protect the fish body from tearing by the friction of the water. There are various types of scales like the placoid, ganoid and elasmoid. Elasmoid scales have the bony ridges that are attached to the skin of the fishes. There are two types of elasmoid. like the cycloid and the tenoid. Let us discuss one by one. Placoid scale. These are the small triradiant, that is, they have the three rays which is oriented from the fish body. It is dermal in the origin. They are attached to the dermal layer of the skin. There are three rays, that is tridon spines. They are composed by hard calcareous substances and which is covered by the dentile protein. These scales are found in the skin of shark, skate and rays. Here we can see the detailed structure of the placoid scale. There is a dermis, epidermis and the pulp cavity seen inside the fish, inside the scale. It is covered by the enamel like hard calcareous protein. Next scale is ganoid or the rhomboidal scale. The name is ganoid scale is originated because it is made up of the inorganic bone salt called as a ganoin protein. These scales are somewhat rhomboidal in shape, diamond shaped, and they do not overlap each other. They are interconnected. They fits together like a piece of jigsaw puzzle or the tiles like in our home. It is seen in the gars, leeches and the reed fishes. Next is a cycloid scale. Cycloid scale is somewhat circular in the shape. They have the middle nucleus part around which concentric lines of growth are originated. There are the longitudinal grooves which are used for sucking the nourishment from the fish skin. By these concentric lines of growth, one can calculate the age of fishes. They show the overlapping structure. It is seen in the salmon and the carp fishes. Next one is a tenoid scale, which is somewhat look like a cycloid scale. But the difference is that here we can see the minute teeny or the teeth-like projection. These are also thin, flexible and the overlapping. These are seen in the modern bony fishes such as sunfishes and the perches. One can calculate the fish age by seeing the concentric lines of growth. Also, fish growth is reflected in the scale growth. That is, the scales are larger than fish age, older in the age. Scales are continuously growing and also they are temperature dependent. Here we can see that many concentric links are accumulated there, from which we can conclude that fish is of 3 years old, because there are first annulus, second annulus and third annulus rings are concentrated. Next organ is a fish fins. These are important organ which is seen only in the fishes. There are two types of fishes. Fish fins are seen. Some are unpaired and some are paired. Unpaired fins like the dorsal fin, caudal fin and the anal fin. And the paired fins are like the pelvic fin and pectoral fin. Fins are adapted for the movement of the fishes. These are important for the fish while swimming, also for giving the direction during the swimming. Okay, let us discuss one by one. Medial or the unpaired fins. These fins have the fin rays which is made up of the bones or the cartilages. First is the dorsal fin. As a name, it is present on the dorsal side, that is the back of the fish. It increases the lateral surface of the body during the swimming and thereby provide the stability while fish is swimming. Next is a caudal fin or the tail fin. It is located posterior end of the fish and it provides the power to move a fish forward. Also, it helps in giving the direction during the swimming. Next one is the anal or the cloacal fin. This fin is located near the anus or the cloaca at the ventral surface. It also used to stabilize the fish while it is swimming. Now let us discuss paired fins. There are two types of paired fins. First one is a pectoral fins, that is homologous to the front legs of the animals. Also pelvic fin, which is homologous to the hind legs of the animals. These fins are sometimes attached to the abdominal region or sometimes attached to the thoracic region. Here in the diagram, we can see that pelvic fins and also the pectoral fins. Okay, pectoral fins. These fins are located near the gills at the anterior side. These are adapted for the walking, especially in the lobe-like fins. Also, this controls the controlled directional movement up and down, or the side-to-side movement of the fishes. Next one is a pelvic fin that is attached to the somewhat abdominal region of the fish. It assists the fish in going up or down through the water, also turning sharply and stopping quickly. This is function like a hind lips. Okay, sometimes these both fins are attached at the abdominal region, so they are known as the abdominal pelvises. In diagram we can see that. Next are the thoracic pelvises. Here the both fins are attached at the thoracic region near the gill side. In these fishes, we can call as a missing pelvises. In this, both the pelvics and the pectoral fins are absent. Example as the lampreys, hagfish, etc. Next one is a caudal fin. The caudal fin is the tail fin, which is known also as a tail fin. It is located at the posterior end and it is used for the propulsion, that is moving forward in the water. We can see that various types of caudal fins are seen here. Variations are seen like the heterocercle, protocercle, diphycercle, homocercle, etc. Also, there are some modification like the protocercle, which is also known as a diphycercle, then modified diphycercle, heterocercle, hypocercle, homocercle, abbreviated homocercle, and gyphyrocercle. Heterocercle caudal fin. In this, the both lobes, that is upper lobe and lower lobes, are unequal. They show the variation. Because the vertebrae is extended into the upper lobe, so it looks longer as compared to the lower. It is seen in the paddlefish and cartilaginous fishes. Next are the modified heterocercle. These are some modification we can see here. Next one is a diphycercle. In the diphycercle, the vertebrae extended at the tip of the tail, so it looks like symmetrical. Both lobes look symmetrical. These are seen in the lungfishes, lampreys, and coelacanth. Next one is a protocercle tail. Protocercle, in which the vertebrae is extended to the tip, but it is not expanded. So we cannot distinguish the upper lobe and lower lobe. This is seen in the This was seen in the fishes which was the now fossilized, like the cyclostome and the lancet and hagfish. Next is a hypocercle, which is reversal to the heterocercle. In the hypocercle, the vertebrae is extended at the lower lobe. So lower lobe is seen longer than the upper lobe. It was seen in the fossilized ostracoderms. Next one is a homocercle. In the homocercle tail, both the lobes are equal. They show the symmetry, but in fact vertebrae is not extended to the, it is extended to the very short distance. It is seen, it shows the variation like the pointed, rounded, truncated, imaginated, fork, lunate, etc. Some common type of caudal fins that are homocercle we can see here. In the first we can see that rounded. Next one is a truncated, in which the vertical edges appear. Next is a forked, in which two ponges are seen. Next is a imaginate, in which inward curve is seen, and in the lunate crescent moon-like shape is appear. Next organ is a barbels. Barbels are important because these are the tactile organ which is located near the mouth. They show some taste bud, which is used for searching of the food in the muddy water. The examples are the catfishes, loaches, hagfishes, sturgeon, and the minnows. They show variation in their barbels. Next important organ in the fish is seen, that mouth. Mouth shows the variation like the superior, terminal, and inferior. In the superior, mouth are turned upward direction, that is at the surface oriented. In the terminal mouth is located at the snout region. It is straightforward. And at the inferior side, mouth is turned downward in the bottom direction. Here we can see the variation seen in the mouths. Next important organ is the gills opening and the single operculum. Gills are the important organs because it helps the fish in breathing. It helps in exchanging gases with the environment. The gills functions as a counter current exchange because both the blood and the water both flows in the opposite direction to each other. This helps in increase the oxygen rich intake water. These gills, some fishes, these gills are covered by the operculum, which the flap like opening. During the breathing, it opens, and when the breathing is stops, it get closed. It is seen in the cartilaginous fishes and also in the primitive fishes. There are gills opening seen externally, which number is ranges from 5 to 7 slits. In the figure, we can see that longitudinal line-like gills opening are seen, which is known as the gill slits. In the some fishes, it shows pores. There are 7 pores present in some fishes. Okay, next breathing organ is a spiracle. In some fishes, extra organ which is used for intake of oxygenated water is seen as a spiracle. Spiracles are small holes which is present near the eye, and it draws the oxygenated water without drawing through the gills. In the diagram we can see that. Next organ is the nostrils. Nostrils are the two opening on the nose which is present on the head. It is used for the sense of smell because in the fishes it also functions as a in searching of the food. Also it warms them from the danger. Next important organ is the lateral line. It is important because it divides fish into two parts, dorsal and the ventral. The LLO, that is lateral line organ system, is a sensory organ found in the fishes which is used to detect the movement, vibration and the pressure gradient in the surrounding water. This allows the fish to determine the direction and rate of the water. As we here, we discuss all the external morphology of the fishes. Thank you.